Hello everybody, Andrea Majewski here with Dentalelle. So this will be a very interesting video. I have not done one on this topic before. This is about how dentistry has changed. So I'm going to talk about the dental office in general, not too much about that, but I'll be focusing on oral hygiene aids and just how things are different. It's not as simple as just saying, okay, brush every day, twice a day, make sure to floss every day, maybe use a mouthwash, have your teeth cleaned every 6 months. It's so much more than that, because we all know that our teeth, our mouths aren't all the same. Some of us have cold sensitivity. Some of us just need extra stuff, basically, right? If you go to the dentist and you get cavities every single time, that's not normal, but we have things now that can actually help you with that. Whereas before, we might have said, well, limit sugar and brush more. Well, it's a lot more complicated than that. Not complicated, but before, we didn't realize that your saliva plays a big part in that. And once more dentists, once more dental hygienists realize that and really start taking the courses, doing the research, as I'm a nerd. I tell my patients all the time, I take courses. I'm always sort of doing research. I teach dental hygiene and dental assisting students as well. So I kind of have to be on top of things. Plus having this YouTube channel, I need to be on top of things too, right? But so let's just talk about a couple things. So first of all, you may have noticed that when you have gone to the dentist to get x-rays taken, we have digital x-rays now. You might be thinking, wow, exciting, not really. Well, actually, it is quite an amazing thing, because digital x-rays have now 50 to 80% less radiation overall. So that is amazing, because everybody says, even if you don't say it, you're probably thinking it, you don't want x-rays taken because you're worried about, well, are they exposing me to more radiation than I need to be exposed to? It's not that much. Yes, radiation adds up over time, so I do feel that I do have to say that, but taking two x-rays, just as an example, they say is the same thing as being out in the sun for 12 hours. So kind of put that into perspective, that's minimal radiation. And now with digital x-rays, 50 to 80% less. And the most important thing for us as a dental professional almost is that we can see the x-rays right away. So we don't have to take the x-rays, wait 10 minutes to put them through the processor developer. I had to do that because I've been practicing now for almost 15 years. I had to do that for about 2 years, and I don't even remember it because it was such a long time ago, but thankfully it didn't last long. So digital x-rays is an amazing thing. Another thing that I want to talk about, which your dental office may not be on top of yet, it seems to be a very slow thing that's coming, but as soon as it was allowed and came to Canada, I was all for it. And that is, if you have a little cavity, you do not need a needle, you do not need a high-speed handpiece to drill into that cavity to take it out. Everybody's worried about getting cavities because they think, oh, now I need a needle. Now I have to sit through the dentist chair and go through a drill, that horrible noise. Ugh, nobody likes that, right? You don't need to do that anymore. But let me say though first, if it's a larger cavity, meaning if you've left it there for too long, you do still need to do the old traditional method of needing a high-speed handpiece to take that cavity out and put either a silver filling or a composite tooth-colored one inside the tooth after that. Not a big deal, right? But if you can avoid that, that's preferred. If it's a small cavity, this little bottle here, let me show you guys that. I use this in my practice multiple times a day. Sorry, I'm trying to focus on it, but it's not really letting me, but that's okay. This little bottle here, all we need is one drop, literally one drop, covers about 2 to 4 teeth, depending on the surface area. This will actually kill that cavity inside the tooth and then seal up that area, so the cavity doesn't have oxygen to thrive in, if that makes sense, because the bacteria that's involved in a cavity needs oxygen to live and get larger, for lack of a better explanation, right? I'm not a scientist, but that's just kind of it in layman's terms. So this little drop actually can go inside the cavity. It kills the cavity right away. It does turn that area black though, not the whole tooth, but that area does turn black. But then it becomes hard about 24 hours after that. And that means that that cavity has been killed, for lack of a better word. It's been killed and then sealed up so that that cavity cannot get larger. Amazing, right? Amazing. And no, there's no catch. The only catch I would have to say is that it does turn the area black. So let's say you had a cavity over, you know, here. You might not want that, but things can be done to lay what's called a temporary glass ionomer material over top to kind of cover up that black area. If you wanted something more permanent, then yes, you have to go back to getting a needle and then the high-speed handpiece to take out the blackness and then put a filling over top. So when you're going that way, then you might as well get the traditional filling anyway. But this stuff's amazing. It works. It's amazing for children who the parents don't want to put them to sleep. Even for adults, it does not matter who. Just if you have a small cavity, you don't need a needle. You do not need a high-speed handpiece. This little drop is literally all you need. If you have any questions about it, let me know. But this is a big thing that has changed. It has been around for a while, more recent to Canada the past couple years, but it works. I have seen it in my patients where I will, if they have a couple cavities, I will add a drop to each one. I will see them back in about 2 months just to make sure that that area is nice and hard. It is hard as a rock, meaning that's a good thing, meaning it has sealed up the area, no more cavity, no more pain. They don't have to go through needles, high-speed handpieces. Children, this is amazing. We all know that two-year-old that might have cavities. They can't sit still. Hopefully they can sit still for like 30 seconds for this. Done. No need to worry. Okay, another thing is that I personally love, I have just started using this the past month. So not a crazy long time, but it is called Crystal. Again, this little drop can help to stop tooth sensitivity. Okay. Literally, it is amazing. The science behind it, I kind of feel like I have to look it up again, but it has to do with crystals, crystallizing to work with your enamel to cover up those areas that are sensitive, helps to bring back that enamel that has been lost, leaving a thin like layer over top. You can't see it, you can't feel it, but it is there to prevent sensitivity from coming back. So we no longer say, oh, your teeth are cold sensitive, use Sensodyne and that's it. If Sensodyne doesn't work for you or you need something else, this little drop makes all the difference. It does take about a minute because we have to apply it for a good 20 seconds on, 20 seconds off to make sure it's as dry as possible. And then if you're still sensitive, we can do another application and then done. This stuff lasts for 6 months. It's amazing. If you have that tooth where you're cold sensitive or you're eating something and you're like, oh, that is always so sensitive, and you've been to the dentist, we can't figure out why, I bet we have not tried this yet. So there are things we can do to stop that cold sensitivity from happening. Amazing. If your gums have kind of shrunk back a little bit. So if we say to you, you know, gum recession is a little bit, you know, here, there, and there, this will actually cover up those areas so that they're not sensitive and helping those areas to not become even worse. An amazing product, new to our dental field. It is amazing. I have seen amazing things. I have seen patients who are in so much pain just from their tooth being cold sensitive. They haven't been able to eat certain things for years. I apply this, they kind of go, oh, I'm kind of skeptical, but put it on, why not? See if it works. they come back wanting more because it works that well. So it's amazing. Another thing, toothbrushes, you guys. Toothbrushes are getting more exciting. Whoops. There we go. Check those out. Nice, eh? Let me just, you know, aim those a little closer for you guys. So toothbrushes are getting more exciting, okay? No more of those, you know, non-exciting toothbrushes. Yes, always make sure your patient has a nice soft toothbrush, but we can do so much more than that. You need ultra soft because if they're pushing too hard, they can make things worse. This can be used with or without toothpaste. I have always loved my electric toothbrush, okay? And these have even changed too, okay? There are so many electric toothbrushes out there. It's amazing, but that's a good thing. And you don't have to spend a car payment now to get a good electric toothbrush, okay? This one was about $54. So I can leave the coupon for you guys on the bottom of the video if you want. I don't make any money by telling you guys to buy this toothbrush. So you don't have to think that I'm just saying that to make money. No, we are not allowed to make any commission here in Canada. So I just kind of wanted to mention that because I have been getting a couple messages asking if I truly do like certain things. Yes, if I'm talking about it, it's because I use it. But I love my electric toothbrush. But since I've tried these, I love them just as much. Your teeth will feel so clean afterwards, and you can use them with or without toothpaste. They do that good of a job because I do have patients that don't like toothpaste or they don't like the taste of things. So these are awesome. Another thing, you guys, is a proper mouthwash. You don't want alcohol. You do not want alcohol in your mouthwash, okay? I have to say that because that can actually dry out your tissues, making things worse. It can just cause more problems, okay? And typically, if somebody's looking for a mouthwash, it's because they want to treat something, right? So a mouthwash. So mouthwash with xylitol is now what you want because this will actually help to change the pH in your mouth, which is amazing because anytime we eat, drink anything, our pH goes way down, which is way too acidic, causing cavities. So if you're that person where you get a lot of cavities, it's likely because your pH in your mouth needs to be changed up. A mouthwash with xylitol helps to change your pH back to neutral. We have never had anything like that. You know, typically if a patient comes in with 5 cavities every time, we say you must be doing something wrong, brush better, stop eating sugar. And they say to us, but I'm not. Like, I'm doing everything I can. Why am I getting cavities? And then we say, I don't know. That's just weird, you know? Well, now we will say use this mouthwash after you eat, if you can, that will help to stop those cavities from even happening in the first place. Because if your pH inside your mouth is of a neutral pH or pretty close, it can't cause a cavity. Without boring you with too many details, a cavity can start as high of a pH as 5.5, okay? So neutral pH is 7, so that's not much lower. So do everything you can to keep that pH up so you don't get cavities. Plus, if you have gingivitis, excuse me, if you have gingivitis, rinse with this twice a day. It will help so much. You will notice a huge difference in about 3 days. 2 weeks, you'll notice more of the difference. Keep using it until the bottle's empty and you will be like, wow, that has made such a difference in my mouth. So we have things that you can now purchase that can actually help at home. So I'm just always so excited about things like that. Trust me, I'm excited because I like to focus on prevention. So something else. If you have dry mouth, okay, even so much as last year, I would be telling patients they have nothing out there that actually helps, in my opinion. Though that company, Biotene, some patients say that it is amazing and some say it does nothing for me. So I was just telling patients, try that company. They have toothpaste, mouthwash, everything. If it doesn't work, there's just nothing else out there. These are amazing, okay? Seriously, you would put them sort of where your, sorry, you guys probably can't see that, but there's a picture. Can you guys see that? Where your attached gingiva is. Now, if you're a patient, you probably don't know what that is. So kind of like up here, you would leave it there, and then this helps to make more saliva, and you can even have it in while you go to sleep. This stuff works. It's amazing, okay? So I was quite excited to be able to actually find something that works. Toothpaste, last but not least, let me talk about toothpaste for a second. There are things we can do to help you, meaning everybody should probably be using a different toothpaste, okay? Like Crest, Colgate is not enough for a lot of people. If you get a lot of cavities, we have a toothpaste for you. If you don't like taste, this is actually a very mild taste, so it's not too bad. But there's a bubblegum flavor too that actually tastes better than the mint for children. But if you're not a child, if you're a teenager, adult, senior, it doesn't matter, and you get cavities or you want to prevent cavities, this toothpaste is amazing because once again, you guys, it contains xylitol to actually change the pH in your mouth to stop those cavities from forming in the first place. Another thing, something other than Sensodyne, and this is actually my toothpaste, hence why it's not in a container. This stuff is amazing because it will actually help to prevent cold sensitivity. It helps, oh, I got something on my lip there. It helps to keep your teeth as white as possible, okay? It's not a whitening toothpaste, but I find with my teeth, stain doesn't seem to stick as well, which is what this toothpaste does. It is amazing. I can't say enough about this toothpaste. It does help to prevent cavities. It does help to keep stain off. It does help to prevent cold sensitivity. If you have teeth that are just, you know, hurting you sometimes, try this toothpaste. This will help. If you had a tendency of brushing too hard, so there's a couple spots where you're like, yeah, it's kind of cold sensitive here, cold sensitive there, brush with this toothpaste. You will notice a huge difference, even so much after a couple days. Like, this stuff's amazing. So we just have so many things now that we can offer you. No more of, oh, you're cold sensitive, you have cold sensitivity, well, just don't eat ice cream, we can't do anything for you. There's so much more we can do for you. So it's so important that if you're a patient seeing this, talk to your dental hygienist. Tell them everything that you might not like about your teeth, or you just want things to change. If you're concerned about something, you know, if you say, well, why do I have a cavity every time I come here? What can I do to stop that from happening? If you are a dental professional, you know, do some research, you guys. Look into these things and test them. Test them on your patients. They work, because I totally understand, you know, you thinking, you know, saying, well, my office isn't going to purchase anything new because we've been using the same stuff for 30 years. That seems to work fine. Get out of that. Try something new. There are newer things happening and your patients will thank you. What else, you guys? Am I missing something? Like, what has been a big change in the dental profession? Let me know, please comment, because I'm probably missing something. I always try to keep the video short and sweet. It never works, but thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for always commenting, because that means, sorry, there's a little hair here. Oh my goodness, I just noticed I have pen all over my arm. Clearly, I saw patients today. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't yet, please make sure to click like, because it just helps me know that people are actually interested in what I'm talking about. And if you click subscribe, I think it's the upper right hand side, that would be awesome too, because that again tells me people are listening. So that would be awesome, you guys. Thank you so much. And if you have any questions, let me know.